channel. So today I'm here with a very simple makeup look which many of you had asked. Doing base makeup is a very big process when it comes to bridal makeup, and that is what I tried to explain in my previous video. My intention was not to make you all do so many steps and say that you have to do an orange corrector, you have to do a concealer, highlighting concealer, foundation. That was not the intention of that video. That video was put up so that you learn how to use each and every product. For example, in that video, if you use an orange corrector, if you have extremely dark pigmentation, top it off with a concealer and set it with a powder, you're ready to go. So you can pick what steps you want to do and what steps you want to leave. So I was only talking about the importance of each and every step, and my intention was not to say that you all have to get ready in, you know, such an elaborate procedure. That wasn't my idea. So today's look is going to be this. It's a very subtle, beautiful, luminous, feminine look, and this is what I do on a day-to-day basis. These are the products that I use on a day-to-day basis that I'm really comfortable using. So before we move into the video, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon so that you're notified whenever I post a video. I will be very grateful to all of you if you can subscribe to my channel. It'll do a whole lot of good to me. So if you all want to know how I got this look, then keep on watching. So when it comes to everyday makeup, cleansing, toning, moisturizing is very important. I've already cleansed my skin, I have already toned my skin, so I'm going to moisturize it now. I have already used a lip balm as well. So for the moisturizer, I'm going to use the Aveeno moisturizer. I had shown this in the base makeup video as well. It is one of my favorite moisturizers. The skin feels nice and soft. So after the moisturizer, I'm going to go in with a stroke cream. So when it comes to everyday makeup, people don't like using a lot of highlighters, or you know, it makes you look very sweaty. That's what I have been told by many people when they try to wear highlighters on a daily basis. People are not very fond of highlighters, but a very luminous finish on the skin is very important when it comes to everyday makeup. I really love that kind of a finish, and that is achieved by using a stroke cream under my foundation. So this is the MAC stroke cream, and it's in the shade Gold Light. It's a very nice stroke cream. There you go, I've taken a teeny bit in the back of my palm. This stroke cream basically is very hydrating as well. And the moment you put it on your skin, this pearl color cream, you know, it sort of turns into a gold color cream. Like I had mentioned before, a gold color or a yellow color is very flattering on Indian skin tones. So next up, I'm going to go in with a primer. I'm using the LA Girl Pro Prep Primer. This is the HD Primer. It's the smoothing face primer. It's a very nice drugstore product. I use this, you know, almost on a daily basis. It's a silicone based primer. Why using a silicone based primer is always good is because silicone based primers goes and sits inside your pores. It forms like a smooth layer on top of your skin. So one, the product is going to, you know, layer on, and it's going to look very nice. Your skin is going to get absolutely mattified. The second and the most important thing is you will tend to sweat less. That is what you require when you are doing makeup on a daily basis. The silicone based primer has gone only into my T-zone now. I think you can make out my face, you know, looks sort of very mattified, and you know, it's not reflecting light, whereas this portion, because I've used the stroke cream, it looks very luminous. So today, to cover all the dark spots on my face, I'm going to use a concealer. This is a cream based concealer. On a daily basis, using a cream based concealer is very good. One, you do not have to layer too much of product on your skin. A little product, you know, will give you a better and full coverage. That is a very nice thing about a cream based product. I'm using the MAC Studio Finish Concealer in the shade NC35 and NC42. I'm going to mix both these shades and sort of, you know, see where my dark spots are more. I'm going to use an NC42 in the areas where my dark spots are more, and I'm going to use an NC35 in which the dark spots are slightly lesser. So I'm taking a small brush. This is the Colourbar brush in 225. This is an eyeshadow brush and it's got, you know, real hair. So I also prefer to use cream products on this. So there you go, I've placed the concealer on all the dark spots. So my dark spots will get concealed now. I'm going to go in with a beauty blender and just, you know, sort of blend this into my skin. You don't want to move the product around too much when you're, you know, spot correcting, because this is a technique of spot correcting. We are not using the product all over the face. Wherever we have problems, we are targeting that area and we are correcting that area. So like you can see, I've covered all the dark spots on my face. Next, I'm going to go in and give a little dimension. What do I mean by dimension? So after using all these products on my face looks, you know, very, very flat. There are no contours. God has given you natural contours under the eyes, in the cheekbones. Your natural contours are there. But when you put a single layer, colored foundation on your face, that contour sort of gets cut out and your face looks very, very flat and artificial. So to bring back a little dimension, I'm going to use a lipstick. One single product for the cheeks, for the eyes and for the lips. So today I'm going into using the matte lipstick. It's the matte variant in the shade Mer. It's a very, very nice, you know, pink shade, a very beautiful shade. I really love this lipstick. So first I'm going to go over my eyes. You might be wondering why I'm using so much product. I do like to go a little overboard with this product because the step which is going to follow this is going to, you know, sort of reduce the effect of the pinkness that this lipstick gives you. So I like to go a little overboard. Cheeks. So first I'm going to go and blend it out on my cheeks. This product, you know, doesn't dry down so quickly. So it gives you that leverage to, you know, blend out and give you a very seamless finish on the face. So it's very nice to use this product as you know, cream blush or whatever. I still don't own a cream blush. I, you know, just prefer using my lipsticks, my creamy lipsticks, and, you know, use it as a blush. So like you can see, I've blended it out on my cheeks. It might look a little too much now, but trust me, it is going to sheer down a lot. It's all according to you, whatever you're comfortable with. You can use a brush as well for this. I prefer using my fingers. So there you go. Like you see, now I've got a little dimension on my face. The blush and the, you know, eyeshadow sort of gives you a little dimension and a little blush, flushed look on the face, and that's very important. So now, as you saw, I used a concealer and I used a lipstick. Both these are cream products. When we use cream products on the face, it's very important to set it with a powder. Otherwise, the product is going to move, you're going to sweat, and it's going to look very, very patchy and cakey and streaky. So today I'm going to use the Huda Beauty Easy Bake Setting Powder. This is in the shade Banana Bread. Yeah, it's in the shade Banana Bread. It's a very, very nice powder and it's a translucent powder. So you don't have to worry about, you know, this going overboard. It has got a slight tint to it as well. I'm dunking my beauty blender into it, tapping off the excess, and I am going all over my face. You can go over all the cream products that you have used, and it's gonna, of course, slightly sheer down that pinky effect that this has on your skin. I love doing this step because all the products on my face don't move after I do this particular step. Like you can see, my face is all done. I have, you know, used the Easy Bake and set my face. So if you are of an oily skin type, you can definitely go in to use a compact powder. This is the Pack palette. I have a Pack palette because I'm a makeup artist. You don't have to invest in it and get all these shades. You can definitely go in just your T-zone with a highlighting powder shade. So I'm going in with this shade and just under my eye, on my nose, forehead, and here. This step is important only if you are of an oily skin type, and just, you know, to dust your face with powder is very, very nice so that you don't sweat a lot. So I finished up everything. Like you saw, I also used a compact powder on my face, so of course my makeup is not gonna budge. Next, for my eyebrows, I had mentioned already in the video that I had put up about you know, doing your brows, this product Nykaa Oh My Brow is something I really, really love, and I use it on a daily basis. I would just use this product on my eyebrows because I like to set the brow hair into its position and, you know, give it a slightly feathered out look with this product. And that's it, my brows are done. I don't do too much with my brows. Now for the lips, I have already used a lip balm. And I've taken that out of my lips. So I'm taking a lip pencil basically here. This lip pencil is in the shade Soar. It's from MAC. It's a very, very nice pink shade which is gonna match the MAC Mer lipstick that I have. So first I'm gonna line my lips and fill my lips with the same product. So there you go, I filled my lips with the same product. Now what do you do for your lipstick to last longer? It's a very, very big problem which many of us face. So I'm gonna take a tissue paper over here. I've dunked it with some loose powder. I'm patting it on my tissue paper and so there you go. The powder sort of sets the cream product. Like I had mentioned, you have a cream product, you set it with a powder. So I have set my lips with a powder now. Then I'm just gonna go in with a MAC lipstick. So there you go. My makeup is absolutely done, but there is one final and very, very important step which I love to do, that is apply a mascara. On a daily basis, I do not wear lashes obviously. So what I do is I curl my lashes. Curling the lashes gives it a, you know, very open and beautiful look. Whereas when your eyes, you know, are normal, that is your lashes are not curled, your lashes tend to face straight like that and it gives like a very droopy, sleepy look. But when you curl the lashes and apply a mascara, it sort of opens up the eyes and makes it look very accentuated, and that's a look I really, really like on a daily basis. So I'm taking a lash curler over here. So as soon as I finish curling my lashes, the most important thing is to set it with a mascara immediately. Oh, I had forgotten to mention, I am using the Faces Canada Magnetic Eyes Mascara. It is my favorite mascara for an everyday use. It, you know, sort of lengthens the eyelash and it gives it also a little bit of volume, and I like the applicator a lot, so this is a very nice mascara again. So I finished my makeup. As a final step, I'm taking the beauty blender over here. I am going to spray it with a little bit of setting spray and then gonna, you know, tap it at the back of my hand and tap it all over my face. So yes, my lovely people, that was the tutorial of today. It was a very, very simple tutorial. I went into explaining each and every step, but practically it takes me 5 minutes to get ready in this way every morning. I hope this video was helpful and I hope you learned something from this video. So before I log out, I'd like to talk about the earring that I'm wearing. It is from Ruse Makeover Studio. This is a beautiful onyx stone earring and it's got American diamonds in it. It's a beautiful, beautiful earring with semi-precious stones. It's a wonderful piece. It's one of my favorites from Ruse Makeover Studio. There are a lot of pieces available. It costs 1,200 rupees. If you'd like to purchase it, do leave a comment below or get in touch with me on my Instagram page, which I will be linking in the description box below. So I hope you all like today's look. It's a very, very simple look, not like the steps that I had shown in the previous base makeup video. I hope you all can follow it easily and I hope you all learned something from this video. I'll see you all in another video, and before you log out, don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell so that you're notified whenever I post a video, and if you like the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Bye-bye.